courier of the high school band directing world, Dr. Andrew Poor. Student leaders include Amber Hightower, Devonna Fitton, Clarence Chiappa, Victoria Richburg, Gabrielle Jones, Brianna Satterwhite, Jason Mosel, Jaden Jede, Grant J. Plowden, Brian Lebrecht, Steve Elise Martinez, Kayla Poor, Mary Zatelli, Wyatt Plan, Kevin Pender, Keandra Diamond, Zane Poskovich, Daniel Lapsus, and Jamie Gasline. The Marching Tigers are under the field direction of drum majors J.P. Pooh Bear Davis, Cooper Haywood, Brittany Ganning, and Elizabeth Pagan Pagan, performing their 2012 program, The Lighter Side of Darkness. Fayette County High School proudly presents the Marching Band from Tigerland.
Being a junior during marching band, I like being a senior because
being a junior in the marching band, I feel like now we have credibility because like sometimes Dr. will ask the rookies to ask us things instead of like asking her stuff or something like that. And also,
my favorite part about being a sophomore is that I wasn't a rookie anymore. And so whenever I'd make a mistake, people didn't say rookie mistake because it was annoying and I didn't like it.
I was just kind of like, oh, it's almost over, but I'm still excited. And then after like the last game, the seniors were talking about their experiences and I was just like, oh, they're leaving. Now we're just going to be on top and all my friends are gone, but it's our time to shine next year, so I'm excited.
Why do I like being a senior?
Because you could pee on people to mark your territory.
Like, I'm sad because next year is going to be us being a seniors and then we're going to be leaving, so yeah.
I think it was really fun and it was nice to like be able to interact with a lot of people a lot older than me.
We all ignored her. She didn't interact.
That's not true.
And it also makes me remember that we only have 1 year left in marching band.
I'm so sad.
Yeah, even though it was bittersweet, I really enjoyed being a senior and one of the top leaders in the marching band. It's definitely been like one of the best experiences that I've ever had in high school.
Why do I do marching band? Pat.
You say pass?
Pat.
I do marching band because the friends and the memories are made.
And you're getting football games for free.
I saw a lot of my older friends were doing it, and they said it was fun. And so I joined it to become closer with new people.
And because I remember being in eighth grade, coming to rookie camp, and just doing that week, I actually really enjoyed it.
Okay, I did it because I didn't know that I was going to be outside practicing in the hot for like 2 hours a day. But I'm glad I did it. But I think I kind of just did it because Max did it.
I feel like marching band is a place where you can get close with friends over a course of many years and you can talk with them and have a place in high school.
I do marching band because it's like a way of life. I don't know! Oh God, I'm so sorry!
Okay, Brianna.
I was afraid to join marching band at first because like, I thought I'd have to talk to like all these scary old people and like do a lot of work, but it was actually really fun and I enjoyed doing it. I'm glad I did it.
I really just needed something to do because high school was boring.
You can't really answer that question though.
Yeah, you can.
Well, I mean, I can. That's what I'm about to try.
Well,
and
why
do.
Why'd you do it?
Or no.
I originally joined marching band. You know, it was just kind of, I don't really remember how I really felt about it, but I remember it was something else that I can get involved with in high school, because I was always trying to look for something just to suit me. And I remember in middle school, you know, I tried to play basketball, that didn't work at all. You know, in any other sport, I'm not really like athletic, but then at the same time, when I joined marching band, it was really athletic, because you get your exercise and everything. And because it's music, I guess I just found what suited me, and because of my decision that I made in joining marching band my freshman year, I'm going into music now in college, and I definitely look back and I wouldn't even take back the opportunity of being in the marching band.
It's like, you know, marching band is different because all the people that are in marching band are weird. There's no doubt about that, but they're only weird because of their passion for music. Like Matt always says, he's always like, who in their right mind would go out in 100 degree weather wearing a cotton uniform, being told where to stand, when to stand, when, where to move, how fast they can move there, and when to breathe, and when to move their tongue? That's just insane. Oh.
Well, I love marching band the most in the aspect of, I don't know, performing in front of people, in front of many different crowds and stuff. Like VOA, all those people are silent just to watch you, you know. You get to show out, you get to have fun on the biggest platform, the biggest stage in existence.
I think my most favorite are the performances that are not like the most intense, but there is really exciting. There's something so exciting about performing at the big competitions like Bands of America and the local competitions because everybody's so quiet when you go on the field and they're ready to watch you. Like they're like, okay, what are you going to give us? And then it's just kind of like you want to put on like the best show that you can for them. And that's like probably my favorite thing about marching band is being able to perform my best for the people that come to see us.
That was really good.
Yeah.
Like everything.
Teamwork, friendship, memories, trips. It all just goes together.
What I love most is the times where we hang out, like during the free time, and how close we become over the months of the marching season, and how when it's over, we still be really close with the ones that you met the first day.
Jamie's favorite part is me. She told me.
My favorite part of marching band is like the friendships that we made, and even though like practices can be really hard and it's a lot of work and we put a lot into it, we still like we get a lot out of it.
Social. That's one of those.
I don't really have one first semester. Because it takes up a lot of time. But after that, we get to spend time with friends.
The people who, my friends that are in marching band, I can't really hang out with them on the weekends because I have marching band practice or competitions to do. But at the same time, all of my other friends that are in marching band, I can just hang out with them and have conversations with them with whatever we're doing.
Okay, I love marching band at all. It's fun. But when you're in band, your life is band. That's all you have is band, nothing else. Practice, can you go to the party? No, because I got practice. It's your whole life.
Because you make a lot of friends, and I feel like marching band helps you keep the same friends like since freshman year, because you always see them, so spend the same people since freshman year, and you just love them more and more every year.
I feel like it impacts it in a positive way, because as a freshman, you know, before you're starting high school, there's already 150 different people that you are friends with, and then you can start high school with all these people, and you're like, hey, what's up? Oh man, nothing, going to eat some lunch, you know? So, and then you just keep those friends over high school, and you have a really strong social base.
One that stands out to me.
When we made finals, BOA, my freshman year, and we had to perform in our little gold dresses in the snow, and Miss Ronan would not let us put on like leggings or stockings because she said cold was a state of mind.
One of my most memorable moments, it's actually freshman year. You know, it's your first year, you don't know what you're doing. Then we go to BOA Ohio, they call our names out for finals, and then next thing you know, they give, you know, 10th, 9th, 8th, and we got 5th. So that's one of my favorite moments. And then this year, playing at the Georgia Dome, I will never forget that. That's a pretty cool feeling.
I don't know. You know what was a really good one, though?
What?
Like, when we were going into the Dome this year, and, like, we were standing there across the front, asking me a picture of it, and I was like, oh my god, Phantom Regiment stood here.
Okay, my favorite memory has been after the Atlanta BOA, when we were sleeping on the turf at Woodward, and then Dr. Roden woke us up by the music, and we all just kind of got up slowly, and then we sat in the circle around her, and we were just in our own little groups, and we were all tired. I thought it brought us closer together.
Corny. Oh. Mine was last year when we made finals, and we all like mingled with everybody, and I just went around and gave like everybody high fives and stuff, and everybody was like, hey, high five, yeah. It made me really happy in the inside.
My favorite memory was the feeling that we got when we figured out that we won Grand Champions, and then just the expression on everybody's face was priceless.
Last year, I'd have to say it was last year when we won Northgate. And that's because I came here expecting, you know, expecting a lot, and I got more than I expected. I noticed the excellence that was going on in the program, and how hard we're worked, and how hard, you know, the staff works, and the dedication. And that's exactly what I wanted from marching band when I came here.
You gotta talk about the apple.
Yeah. Do I have to? Yes. This is lasting forever, though.
Hey.
Some of my head.
Somebody else's hair.
No. Apples.
Sophomore year, band camp. At band camp, usually the parents have fruit and concessions out, like selling to them in breaks. So I was like, okay, and the fruit was free. So I went over, like, their apples, oranges, bananas, and such. I go over and grab an apple, and we start doing marching aerobics. So I'm eating the apple. I'm, like, in the left side of the field or whatever. We're marching. Chad Jacobs is there, coincidentally. And so we're eating, and we do this thing called quarms up, where we put our hands like this. And I have my apple in my hand like this, and I was walking. And as I was walking, I was taking a bite and stuff. And so Chad Jacobs, he stopped everybody, and I was just like, okay. And he walked over to me, and he was like, is that an apple in your hand? And in my mind, I was like, oh my gosh, I can't lie to him. So I was like, yeah. And he's like, just start running. So I get out to the sideline, and then he tells everybody else to start running for that entire day. And still now, everybody hates me because I made them run a lap. But what they don't realize is I ran 4 laps. That's a whole mile. They ran 1. So, yeah, that's my story.
All right. So,
How do you don't have to add this to the video, okay. But did he make a comment like run until
my... Yeah, run until like my soul is tired. And he called me Apple Man, and that has been my nickname for the longest time.
I'm excited. I don't know about you.
I'm up. She said I'm up. You working those black plumes?
He learned that.
Working. I'm so excited. You look so good. Do you understand how good you look? Yeah! And let me tell you something. Tonight is what it's all about. It's all about performing. It's all about performing for those people That video camera's not on it. Turn that thing off just for a second.
Yeah. And the show even today is even better than that. So you actually, you improved a lot this year, mentally and physically. The way you perform and the way you act. And I'm very proud of everything that you've done this year. Some people, you made me a little worried in July and August, but you actually matured a little bit, and you made it happen. So congratulations. So we get two rehearsals, but we still have to rehearse because we have two performances, right? But we still get to have a little fun as our band family. All right, so are you ready?
Yeah. Ready for what?
For Rihanna. Yay! Follow your drum majors.
I kind of feel disappointed, but in the same aspect, we went to a higher level, so I didn't really expect us to do super good going to a higher level, you know, like, if you're doing super good and then you upgrade, you're going to be at the bottom of the pack. It's kind of like high school, sort of, going from 8th grade to 9th grade, you know, but, I mean, we did alright, you know, winning the small competitions and doing alright.
Honestly, I was a little disappointed. Because last year at BOA, when we made finals, Dr. Roden was like, okay, freshman, this is your chance. You know, we started out well. This is your chance to make finals all 4 years. And I really wanted four finals patches. Like, I wanted to be able to say I made finals all 4 years. But we didn't, and that's okay, but a little disappointing.
This year, you know, we won our first competition. We made 14th in the second. And we did really well at Atlanta. But even though we didn't make finals at either of the BOAs we did this year, I feel like the program improved. I feel like we, as a program, we moved forward. And going to Atlanta and having the band see the kind of bands that are at Atlanta, since Atlanta is a super regional and 34 bands went, you know, it just like steps up the bar and shows what the next level and the next step is for us.
I don't know. I think we're good. Like, we're good. We know we're good.
I just feel like it's grown a little bit every year. So, you know, we're probably going to come back like a couple years from now and it's going to be just that much better.
I think the band gets better at every practice and every competition that we do.
I am very, very pleased. We go to our local competitions, do extremely well. We have won several grand championships over the last 4 years, thanks to this senior class. And our competition record at BOA is really good as well. We've made finals, and we've come really close to making finals, but the shows have been really good, and I have seen growth every single year, and that's the most important part.
What do you think the theme of the next show is going to be?
Ooh. I want it to be the Little Mermaid.
It should be Iron Man. That sounds cool.
Oh, I think it would be really cool if they had a Hawaiian-themed show. Since we're going to Hawaii, like, yeah. That would be awesome to like incorporate it into our show next year.
Justin Bieber.
The Avengers, you know, the Avengers with the whole Iron Man, like, repulsor thing, like the Thor, and the thing, the Hulk smash.
I've always wanted it.
Who knows? Like, it's always random.
Oh, I just thought of it. Oh, I would want it to be a superhero theme.
I think that would be cool. Everyone could have a cape. The color guard costumes would be so cute.
Yeah, yes.
I hate when they have ugly color guard costumes.
And then we're just like,
why should it be some like surreal show like finding something underwater somehow?
That's like probably one of my number one pet peeves is when it's a really cool show and then the color guard costumes ruin it because they're ugly.
Yes. All right. When do you think there will be a Star Wars theme show?
Actually, we were going to do that next year. Sorry y'all won't be here for it. So, never!
Really?
Okay. No, I'm kidding. Okay. I'm kidding.
What keeps you in band?
How's it feel? This is your final year. Marching band is over. How's it feel not being able to be a marching tiger next year?
Friends keep me in band. I'm friends, just friends.
It sucks.
It will hit me in a couple of weeks when I have nothing to do after school and I just fall asleep. But it's a good and a bad thing that it's over with.
Because this was my last marching band season ever, I feel really sad that it's over, but I'm also kind of relieved. I'm sad because, like, all the experiences we had were amazing and they're gonna stick with me, like, for the rest of my life. But now I do have more free time to, like, get my homework done and study and get good grades for college and stuff. But I mean, I'm really gonna miss all the friends that I made, and I'm gonna miss, like, getting to perform every Friday night and practicing for something amazing and being able to, like, say I accomplished something. But I mean, it had to end, but I just can't believe that it's finally over. And, like, I've done marching band all 4 years, and it just, like, it really doesn't feel like it's over yet. And I'm really gonna miss it.
I feel like if you leave band, you're leaving a whole base of people. Like, you have one less thing in common with them, so there's less common ground between you guys, so then you have more of a chance to grow apart, I think.
Yeah, like Brianna said, I don't think, like, you tell other people how close you become, and they're like, oh, it's just, you know, it's just marching band, you know, what are you talking about? They don't understand, like, all the time we spend together and how you do become closer. And I feel really sad. I feel like it hasn't hit me yet, because I know marching band isn't over. You know, we have, like, 2 games, you know, Friday, this thing on Friday. But I know that once, like, the last game is going to hit me, and I'm going to be a hot mess.
Right.
I'm going to be crying.
Yes.
Well, now that the season's over, it's kind of bittersweet. You know, the bitter part of it is that, you know, the people that you were always around for, like, almost every single day of the week and every Friday and Saturday, depending on if it was a football game or a competition and stuff, like, there's some people that I got really close with this past season and even the past 3 seasons, and we've just gotten even closer in our friendship. And, you know, that's, like, the bitter part of it, because I'm not going to see them that much, especially now that marching band's over, you know, and I don't see them in school as it is. And then I'm looking ahead and seeing, like, we're going to graduate in May, and it's going to be sad because, I mean, it's bittersweet because, like, I'm going to remember these memories, like, for a lifetime, and they're always going to stick with me. But how often am I going to be able to see these people like I did as a senior in the marching band and over the past 3 years? I even remember my first time stepping onto the football field to perform at that Friday night football game. It was the most amazing experience ever. You know, it was this overwhelming feeling of excitement and, like, wow, I'm a part of something that's amazing, and we create something that's amazing, and we enjoy it.
I'm disappointed as well. I treat this band program like it's my baby, and, you know, like, not, it's like not being with your baby, so.
If you know what that feels like.
Yeah. it's, you always want to take care, I want to take care of it, I want to make sure it does well, but.
Come on, baby.
You know, I'm not going to be here, but there's people I trust that will take care of it and bring it to the next level. I know that the next year I can start focusing on what I'm going to do whenever I'm band director. And the things that I've learned in this program are invaluable, and they're just... I'll definitely be using them in my own program one day.
I think the maturity level of the group has developed a lot. Going back to what I just said about not doing it for the trophies, I see students volunteering for more things. accepting work that we may have to do, whether it's manual labor of moving chairs or anything we have to do, and not having any complaints, at least not outwardly. The work ethic, I think, has really, really improved, and I think that's one of the things I'm most proud of.
I love this band program. Because it's made my life.
Higher feet!
You know, where I became the person that I am today, and just thinking about it and that I'm not gonna be able to that's not me crying. just thinking that I'm not gonna be able to do it next year is like, it sucks because I love these people and I just hope that even though I won't be here, next year, that they'll carry on the legacy that we've been able to set up, that my little brother, when he comes in next year, and he's gonna be like, I see why JP loved this so much. I'm gonna love it just as much, if not more, than he did. Hey,